Well, good afternoon, everyone. Such an honor to be awarded this, the 2014 Buck Buchanan Award on the 20th anniversary. I think you look across the country and you see, I kind of glance at other people's stats, and there's some great talent out there, some great players, and it's very humbling and very big honor to be mentioned along those same names. I've been extremely fortunate since I've been here at NDSU to be around great teammates, great coaches. You just got to hear from Coach Kleiman. And that culmination has kind of got me to where I am today. You know, if it wasn't for my teammates for being a part of such great defense, I wouldn't be here without them. You know, I think it's kind of crazy that no one else has won it, but I think that's kind of the defense we play. And we focus on defense to get off the field. You know, that's our job. We want to be on the field as little as possible, and the offense wants to be on the field as much as possible. So with that being said, I'll open it up to any questions.
Coach said that, I think I asked you about it on media day, about being called the best defensive end in the country. Did you take that as a challenge to get your game to that level?
Yeah, a little bit. You know, when Coach Kleiman said that at the time, I was kind of like, you know, Coach, that's kind of a bold statement right now. You know, I've always had confidence in myself. I knew I could be a pretty good player, but I didn't know if it was necessarily the best defensive in the country. And yeah, I took that a little bit as a personal challenge. You know, I wanted to show people that I could go out and play well, and was lucky to do it this year.
Same time, you also said on media day that this preparation started a long time ago, that you decided when that 2013 season ended, you were ready to prove people wrong. 2014 was going to be just as strong. Talk about that work all year and the education you've put in.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, the second we won in Frisco last year, I think myself and my teammates, we felt this hunger, we felt this drive, this motivation. You know, everyone was talking about how this is the end of an era. You know, we lost everyone, you know, coaching staff, athletic director, you know, everyone was leaving, so 25 seniors. So we were hungry, you know, and I started right away and winter workouts with Coach Kramer. I worked probably as hard as I ever have, and it kind of carried over into the summer. And then into the season, you know, I was lucky enough to have a kind of a lighter load academically, where I had more time to be up there with Coach Kane working, you know, in the film room, and really became a student of the game, and that helped out a lot as well.
Kyle, what was your initial reaction when you heard that you won the award?
Well, it was kind of unique. Coach Kleiman actually told me last night in his office, and you know, I think it was the first time I've ever been recognized somewhere. I didn't find out on Twitter or something, so that was kind of cool. You know, I was just extremely happy, you know, especially share it with Coach Kleiman, someone who means a lot to me, someone who's done a lot personally for me, you know, just sticking around, you know, and I've told him that before, you know, how much he means to the senior class as well as me personally. So it was just a cool moment to be able to share with him.
You notice more blockers coming your way in the last 6 weeks, like Christmas time?
Yeah, a little bit. Kind of got to expect that, I guess. But yeah, kind of running backs chipping, tight ends on the line a little bit. But at the same time, you know, I'll take that if it frees up Mike or frees up Brian or whoever. You know, as long as someone else can get a one-on-one block, you know, that's fine with me. I'll take that.
When you think back to coming out of high school, like, you made a position change, didn't you, into defensive end, making that transition and then the growth you've been able to make. Can you kind of, I know it's far from over, but reflect on this college career right now and how far you've come?
Yeah, it's been crazy, you know. I never really expected to switch positions in the first place. But when I did, you know, it was kind of like, oh, here I go, I start all over again. Defensive end is something I barely played in high school, you know, always never had my hand in the dirt. But it was just a lot of hard work, from myself, from my teammates, from the coaching staff, Coach Kramer. You know, I put on 30 pounds since I got here, I think mostly good weight. And it's, like I said, it's just been a lot of things have gone into it. It wasn't just me personally doing anything. I had a lot of help along the way, and it's really made me into the player who I am.
Some of those guys that came before you, maybe, and because, you know, we've talked about the depth that was ahead of you at defensive end. Can you kind of maybe reflect on some of those?
Yeah,
guys?
I remember Coulter Boyer right off the bat. You know, first move, he was the big time guy right at the time. You know, he was All American, and he really helped me even from a personal standpoint. Just you know, mentally going through a position change, and then starting as a freshman, and you know, he helped me out a lot. With that, and then got to play alongside Cole Jurek, you know, another great player who helped me out. You know, teams had to focus on him a lot when, and now I was fortunate enough to get some one-on-one blocks. So, and then Mike, you know, it's been too bad that he's been injured this year, because I really think he would have had an outstanding year. But you know, he's been a guy that's been with me from the beginning. You know, and there were some tough days there early on, and you know, Mike will tell you that. And we worked through it together, and it's just awesome that we've come this far together as seniors, and we'll see. Hopefully, we can keep it going.
And your Twitter's been going crazy. Anybody that surprised you, made you open your eyes, that sent you a message?
I haven't been able to see them all. I did see Heidi Heitkamp, Senator, send me a tweet, so I thought that was pretty cool. I guess other than that, I haven't seen too much, but yeah, I thought that was pretty neat.
How crazy are these next 48 hours going to be before you, considering finals week, being recognized for this, and then having to prepare?
Yeah, it's going to be a hectic week for sure. I'm just going to try to enjoy this day. You know, I know me and Coach Klein will be looking at some film definitely on the plane. Not going to forget the number one goal to win a game on Friday night. You know, regardless of this award, that's my main focus. And then you know, just try to put those other things aside. Study as best I can for the finals. I get to graduate this week as well, so it's kind of a big week. But you know, I'm ready for it. It's a fun week.
Coach mentioned the Iowa State game is the game that stood out. I know that was a big game since your brother went there. Was that the one for you that stood out this season?
Yeah, that definitely. Just the fact that it was an FBS game, you know, I had like 30 family members there, you know, so a lot of people to watch it. And it's always fun to beat an FBS opponent, and I was fortunate enough to play pretty well that game, so yeah.
What does it mean to you to be an academic All-American?
Oh, that's a big honor as well. You know, my mom always tells me all the time, you know, you did go to college for a reason other than to play football. So she I know she's pretty proud of that. And, you know, I do work pretty hard at my grades as well. So it's kind of nice to get them both recognized.
Coach,